And the idea of like, oh, well, we're going to be inclusive and bring in Aboriginal perspectives into that concentration camp of an institution. It's just sometimes that's laughable to me. The main goal is to prepare students for the workforce. That's it. And we're entering an era now where most people are going to be irrelevant, and they don't know what they're going to do with all these irrelevant people. What are they going to get all these people to do? So they're building a they're building the metaverse now. They're building a digital twin of the world, basically, and of any kind of worlds that people can imagine. It's Ready Player One now. They're working on that. The kids will be expected to go into that, I suppose. But it's they're being trained right now for a workforce that was, for an economy that was, for a world that was. It doesn't exist anymore, and it's not going to exist when they leave school, but they're still being trained for that. It's a nightmare. We still all have all the same goals for education, and we're still following the same policy for a world that no longer exists. It's pretty damn grim. So for me, when I think about Indigenous knowledge, I'm like you, that it's not going to happen in a room under fluorescent lights, on a desk, on a worksheet. That's not where that comes. I don't really care what they have to do there. In fact, I'd rather that they weren't writing. I don't know. I'd rather that they weren't thinking they were getting Indigenous knowledge on that worksheet. I'd rather that they weren't, doing a vocab test or a comprehension test on a dreaming story, because it's inclusive. I saw what that did to my kids going through, and all the token stuff they did at school, and how it broke them. All of that indigenized content, it made them hate themselves.